The Prince of Egypt has brought the world of ancient Egypt to life by expanding the limits of computer-generated imagery and pushing the envelope of technology. Using a revolutionary new piece of software called the Exposure Tool, animators for the first time are able to place hand-drawn two-dimensional characters into a computer-generated three-dimensional world. Characters can move through that world and the camera can follow, bringing the story to the screen in a whole new visual presentation.
With the Exposure Tool, the camera is completely free to move around inside this environment, exactly like Steven Spielberg's live-action camera is able to move around a real set.
Normally, if a 2D background is here and you move the camera, well, suddenly you can see the background on edge and it doesn't quite look as good anymore. Well, what the Exposure Tool does, it'll literally warp the background so that they stay at an approximately correct perspective throughout the process.
One of the neatest scenes we've done using the tool is the chariot race. There's a big pullback. Rameses is in the chariot and we pull back and then we follow him up this hill and over the top of the hill.
It allows us to treat the camera in an action sequence in a very fast, choppy, editorial way, so that we're constantly repositioning and moving the camera, chasing the action.
I think the important thing to say, instead of getting very technical, is a scene that used to take 9 months to try to put together, now you can do them in about 3 days.
DreamWorks enlisted the talents of live-action special effects artists to depict a series of plagues that devastate Egypt.
The plague sequence had huge, massive size and detail. The turning of the Nile to blood, the pestilence, the swarms of locust, and hailfire from the sky. What was unique to each one of those is the complexity, and that's really why we decided to use computer animation on this sequence. The locust scene, for example, had 7 million locusts in it. And I don't know of one animator that could have, or wanted to, draw 7 million locusts. Plague of Pestilence was challenging to the computers. I had to have bugs that crawled on the surface, interacted with items that were on the surface. These bugs were crawling out of bread. They couldn't run into the cups. They had to destroy the bread as they came out. And that was really pushing the envelope as far as technology goes.
The final plague is the death of the firstborn, or what they call the angel of death plague, which claims the life of the firstborn in Egypt. It was conceived as a very organic, vaporous form with the ability to think. The big challenge was to get it to not look like it was created in the computer. There's a particular scene that I really like where there is a painted background and a painted overlay, a middle ground, and in between the two, there's sandwiched the imagery of the angel of death, which is computer generated, and the styles match so well that it's just seamless. The burning bush was described to me as the pivotal moment of the movie. It's the first representation through effects of the presence of God. We are trying to not only be visually spectacular, but try to, on a personal level, touch the viewer.
The Exodus sequence, where Moses leads the Hebrews out of Egypt, adds to the film's epic scope.
As we started to unravel the story, we realized we had to do complete family groupings and walking through the Red Sea, you know, with all of their belongings.
We had no software, we had no talent or expertise that had ever done it before.
We had so many characters, and each one got animated separately.
When you put them in a shot with the traditional characters, right now people are actually asking us which ones are traditional and which ones are computer generated, and that's exactly what we wanted to hear.
One of the most challenging tasks for the effects animators was the parting of the Red Sea.
Animating a miracle is incredible. I mean, how often do you get to animate an act of God?
The parting of the Red Seas is a huge challenge because it's such a pivotal point in the story. And if we didn't deliver the effects properly, it would have let down the story.
The parting of the Red Sea, it had to be huge. It had to have an incredible scale. It had to be scary. It had to be magical. It had to be awe-inspiring. So what we've done is we've created an animated painting, effectively, in the Prince of Egypt. And we've brought the viewer into this environment and immersed them in this experience that you could never film and has never been seen before.
Visual effects in feature animated films are just as computer intensive, creatively intensive as they are in live action films. The Red Sea as a sequence is using over 300,000 hours of rendering time, which is over 32 years of technical rendering time, which is almost double the total rendering time on Titanic. Prince of Egypt uses the technology that is throughout this studio in a way that empowers the artists to tell their creative vision and tell the story without taking the audience out of that story.
This film is groundbreaking, I think, for what people perceive animation to be. I think it's definitely going to change people's minds a lot.
It's an eyeful, it's spectacular, it's different than any animated movie you've ever seen.
What is the most special about the picture is the depth. It has so many layers of meaning and performance and artistry.
The real miracle of Prince of Egypt has been how much great talent there is out there and how much they wanted to join in the dream, how much people were prepared to take a risk.
Jeffrey, Stephen, and David's decision to make this a film that they had to make rather than a film that they were marketing was the best decision they could have possibly made, because the focus isn't on turning out toys, it isn't on doing things that other people want you to do, it's to do a film that they actually think is a good film.
This is one of the few times that I've walked out of something thinking I'm glad I'm a small part of this huge experience. It's a really nice message in a very powerful film.